a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's human fly.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning, human fly, and good morning to your agent, Dave Levine. How long have you fellas been together?
We've been together now for about 9 months.
Might I ask you how tall you are?
I am 6'3".
And about how old are you?
I am 29 years old.
You were involved in a very serious accident in which your wife and your little daughter were killed.
That's right. In Nashville, we were driving along a highway, and I was sleeping in the back seat, and my wife and my stepdaughter were killed.
And that was the beginning
of the human fly.
Why? What was the motivation? What inspired you to become a human fly?
Well, when I was in the hospital, I had a lot of time on my hands, and I was really banged up bad. Doctors said I would never walk again. But I showed them that I had determination. I'm a very aggressive person. I did walk again by the grace of God and through my aggressiveness. And when I got out of that hospital, I wanted to prove to the world, I wanted to dedicate myself to something. And I chose the human fly. It was a great thing, a great idea. And now I've come a long way, and in 9 months, I have become the greatest daredevil that has ever lived.
Why do you wear the mask? Why do you wear the costume?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't want any personal glory. I'm out to make the human fly the greatest thing. And second of all, when I go into a hospital and I visit the children, if I were to go in with just a suit and tie, it wouldn't bring as much great feeling to the kids. When I go into a hospital, I show them that the human fly is the greatest superhero that ever lived. And when I go and I see a child that just had open heart surgery, and I go down and I shake the little boy's hand and I let him hold my magic wand, and I speak to him, and he sees this huge 6'3" guy in a mask costume with diamonds studded and everything, he's inspired. You know, it gives him a chance. It gives him a life wish.
And if you doubt that he's the greatest daredevil in history, take a look at this. Let's roll the film. Let's see Human Fly in action. Tell us about it.
Well, right there, this was my first stunt in Mojave. And right there, I'm coming on a flyby. A flyby is where my pilot goes about 30 to 40 feet above the ground. Now, that's a DC-8. It's very difficult. Our pilot's the best pilot in the world, I would say. I'm on top. Right now, we're doing about 190 200 to 205 miles per hour.
How are you able to hold on?
Well, I have a brace in which I hold on top of the plane. Right there, we're banking. And that's the one time I don't look down is when we're banking.
Now, do you have a little platform up there on the back
of
the plane?
Yes, I have a platform on top of the plane.
And how many shrouds?
Just
how many
two
cables?
For my arms. My arms are free at all times. My arms are free when I'm on top of that plane. And I hold on for dear life.
And you're in some kind of a harness. What is that harness like?
Well, the harness is cables, and it goes on my stomach, on my legs, and it goes into the fuselage of the plane.
How are you able to breathe? After all, you're moving along at a tremendous speed.
Well, I've done extensive training in the wind tunnel, and I've devised a method in which I can breathe. But this feat I'm doing at Mojave this Saturday, tomorrow, is going to be a very big test on me because I'm going to be traveling at 300 miles per hour.
300 miles per hour? What kind of an outfit are you going to have? What kind of a...
Well, the outfit that I use when I am traveling, when I do my feats, is a leather outfit. The same thing, I'd say, in comparison to the motorcycle drivers, what they wear.
But it didn't work last time. We're going to talk about that in just a moment. We'll be back with Human Fly in just a moment. A moment ago, Human Fly, we were watching Cal Worthington. He is an automobile dealer here locally, a great showman, and he said he'd stand upon his head to sell a car. And he actually did. He got a trapeze, and they turned the plane upside down, and there was old Cal flying upside down. Would you do that?
Well, when you're using a DC-8 cannot do spins. But if I can get a plane that can do spins, boy, I'll do anything.
Now, let's talk about the commercial aspects of this. This isn't all just humanitarian in its approach. You've got a little problem and a little plan and a little anticipation going here, David.
George, first of all, I wanted to explain that I represent the company Human Fly Spectaculars, which manages and finances the entire project.
Mm-hmm.
And what we are trying to do is create an awareness for this character that we've just talked to, an awareness so great that we're able to do something with him. And his motives are one thing. We, as a company, have our own motives. And those motives, quite simply, are to, A, inspire these children along with the fly, allow him or give him the opportunity to inspire children, because this is his ultimate dream. And secondly, as a financial investment, we're trying to get a return on this investment.
What are some of the projects you have in mind?
Well, we've recently signed an agreement with Marvel Comics.